And here's our new intro.
Are you looking for answers about extraterrestrials, or maybe the true meaning of life? Then you have come to the right place. Welcome to the Ivan Teller Online Broadcast. Please subscribe to this YouTube channel. And for more details, please visit ivanteller.com and learn more about your galactic families.
How about that?
Hi, Pix. Ivan.
Yeah, what's up? this is the Ivan Teller show, or however you want to call it. This is an online channeling of extraterrestrials. We're going to try Martian and maybe entities in our species in our solar system or whoever comes through. So, would somebody like to do a prayer before we begin?
Yes, sir. Okay. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد تبارك الله العظيم. Blessings to all.
Thank you. As always, thank you everybody for being here. And as for the Martian, I've challenged him before. I don't remember his name. Well, it could be any of any. Anyway, I think a Martian will come through. I believe he will. So there's been a welcome. I sent out a mental hello, so we'll see if he comes through or not. So, all right, catch you guys later. Greetings. Martian, you mentioned about, or called to, however you want to say, did not come through, but I am a Venetian, as some of you call, Venus entity. Greetings, I am from Venus.
Greetings. Welcome to planet Earth, and your name and your physique and everything, please. Introduce yourself.
Yes, my name is Marla. I am a 6 foot, as you call, being from Venus. So I'll just use your terms. It's easier for communication, Papa. It's easier for communication. My reason for being here is find this very curious for an open channel for almost any entity to come through. So I figured I would pay a visit. And some of you might want to know the progress of your solar system or what is going on. So I figured I'd pay a visit. Yes, I understand introductions is most helpful. One moment.
So you're a female?
Yes.
And so what is your skin color and your looks? How is it like?
Blue, humanoid-like. My eyes are larger than yours. My mouth is smaller. Somewhat like a gray, but not necessarily. We don't like that form at all, but I have like an elongated head. I have hair. As for clothing, we do not really need clothing, but some of us prefer that.
Like a jumper.
Yes. Yeah.
You look like more or less to me like a Pleiadian, like. Right?
Yes, that is correct.
Beautiful. So you are adorable. So how you knew about us, of course, through your star friends. And how is your connection with Grafiknir?
Grafiknir. Of course, I'm part of the Galactic Federation of Light. Of course, this is majority of beings are of the light. But also, Grafiknir, I am aware of their presence. Not necessarily, we are in contact with them, but on a brief. We don't necessarily have a day-to-day conversation with them, but we are in communication with them time and time again. Mostly it's for security reasons, such as, or an update of how are things going? Is everything okay over there? Those type of things.
So can you tell us about Mars? There's a mystery about Mars. It's very... Some people say it's very harsh, and some people say it's beautiful, some people say it's weird. So you tell us more about it, please.
Yes. One moment. Yes, Mars is right now in this, you call, a experimental phase. There are many on your planet are there, your elites are there. And many other species, even many that you're not too familiar with. Reptilians are there, mantis, some grays. Many projects are done on Mars right now. As for its terrain, it is, from right now, it's a bluish color at this point. So it's not red. At least from my perspective.
Oh, this is news for us. We know it is red.
Yes, but of course, all this information isn't always correct. And of course, the air is not breathable, at least for your world, but it is adequate for many other species. There's many, as you heard, many underground tunnels, many above ground, but mostly underground, that is correct. Many conspiracies aren't all too far off. Of course, we've seen as conspiracies to throw off the true the truth of what is going on there.
So is it friendly to our planet Earth, or is it just like the others that have loving entities to us, and the others are malevolent entities to us?
Yeah, Martians are no longer on that planet anymore. Now it's more your human. Your kind is there. Many have been abducted. Many part of black projects are happening there. So there's much going on there. You can say it's Earth 2 into some. So it's those conspiracy theories such as, you know, your elites are there. That is very true. There are wars on there. It's a territorial takeover. And it's very controversial. Many of us do not like what's going on. It's very negative over there.
So you're not there anymore. You're not there anymore, right? You left it then. Uh-huh. Here, the floor is yours, at. Go ahead.
Okay. Hi, I'm Jenna. Nice to meet you. I have a quick question. Is there a way to communicate with aliens? And if so, how do we do that? How do we go about that? And how do we know we're actually communicating with you?
Of course, you have to be connected to yourself properly to... You want positive energies around you, of course. You want to have a clear connection. You have to love yourself and have positive entities. Of course, you can always attract negative entities. Those are always easier, of course, but I would not suggest that. But as for... Yes, it's to speak to aliens. Usually the way it works is if you are ready for their communication. That's how it works usually. If you force them to connect with you, they will not. Usually you have to sort of let it gradually happen on its own. As for doing astral, that you can do it that way. As through meditation, you can do it that way also. The more open, you need also another way is to have an open invitation for them to come and visit you. And if they feel that you are ready, they will communicate. Hopefully that helped.
Yes, you did. Thank you very much for your answer.
Anyone? Okay.
I can continue on that part. You can be a member in human colony, and that's easier for you also, right?
Yes.
Good.
Yes, I agree with that. That would definitely help.
Okay.
Sorry.
Okay. I go.
Yes.
Okay.
I go.
So I have a question. I was wondering if I have received an Arcturian infusion of DNA. Because my psychic abilities are getting stronger and stronger, and what is it, Sunday, so yesterday, I was experiencing a lot of stuff that I hadn't experienced before. I was receiving a lot of colors that I usually don't do, and I also was figuring out, I was getting lots of downloads of psychology, and how thoughts were working. So I was wondering if that has anything to do with like an infusion or anything.
Yes, you are correct about with the Arcturian. Yes, it's a male. Also a female, but she does not make herself very noticeable. But yes, there's a male figure there. He feels that you are ready. Of course, you're very eager also, which is fine, which is good. It means you are mature enough to receive this information, so yes. And as I was listening before, earlier, you felt a presence around you, and that is an Arcturian that is making himself known to you.
I have another question for you. You said you were listening.
Yes.
So before you do this, do you just like hang around each individual member and just listen, or do you... Maybe around the
over here.
Ah,
Not yes. That's how that works. So we were already welcome to come through, so we sort of were waiting. In a waiting room, you can say.
That's cool. That's really cool. Same thing we do here. We all wait in line to try to get and ask some questions.
Yes. It's always friendly. It's not, you know, we're not spying on you or anything like that. Not like your governments. That's a different story.
Hello, Marla. How are you?
I am doing well. Thank you.
You're welcome. Much love. I was wondering just, you said are you currently on Venus, or what planet do you reside on now?
Yes, Venus. Right now, I am actually on my ship. Yes, I was going to go into that, and then my mind got caught up in too many different things. I wanted to say two or three things at once. Yes, I'm on my ship outside of Venus right now. As I've heard of your questions, of course, I want to answer something before you ask, such as it's being terraformed, information of that. Yes, but not to an extent that you would expect. There are Hathors on Venus right now working, but they're working at a slow pace, only because the scenario that you heard about your third density being moved over, your world being transferred, that is correct, but it's done in a slow process right now to make sure that everything is done correctly. So, anyway. So you have a question?
I just wondered if you had if I had any connections with the Venusians, and if you could tell me any information about any entities that have any messages for me. I'd really like to channel if you had any info on that.
How fascinating. You know, Venusians, I'm not picking up that, but I'll tell you, that doesn't mean I do not see that as a lifetime with them. Oh wait, one moment, I'm getting my mind confused. Hold on one second. Venus, yes. One moment. Two lifetimes, much done with technology, much knowledge with technology, learning its ins and outs. And as for an entity, when you brought that up, it's very interesting because a frog species came through.
Sweet.
You're aware of this, yes. Very friendly. Shy, and seeing how you're part of this group, and many are curious of who is around them, more are making themselves known. So this is a frog or amphibian species.
Is it related to toad, or is it just another entity? Is it that little leaf wisp that is that plays on my hair and stuff? Or do you have like a name for this one?
It's a green. It's more of a frog type. Toad's a different breed altogether. This is more like a green frog, such as you see those little small frogs. As for the name of its species, they give me names that aren't. Well, one moment. Well, how about if I give you his name? How about this? That'd be a little bit easier. Their name is very complicated.
All right.
All right, one moment. He calls himself... we're doing human names to make it easier. Tyson is the name he gives me.
All right, I'd love to meet him whenever he can show up. Is he physical in form, or is he multidimensional?
Multidimensional, but he can be physical, yes.
All right, I'd definitely love to meet him physically. Thank you.
Part of the fifth and sixth density.
Sweet.
Okay.
Yes.
You okay, Steve? Okay. The question is, before... Oh, yeah, What kind of connection I have with your civilization? I feel your energy.
Yes, you've had many lifetimes on Venus.
As a boy or girl?
Boy, girl, sometimes even... One moment. Even as... I know it's going to sound strange. One moment.
I give you permission to pick in my information.
Thank you. What I have here is 10 lifetimes on Venus. Some of them very long. Most of them positive. I believe there, of course, it was similar to Earth, but nowhere near as complicated. We were, of course, this is, others have their own versions of Venus, because they experience different experiences. But mine is, the times of Venus was of technology, but also love. It was also, such as your SSI, it was somewhat like that. Your Bashar, kind of. Technology, how technology can help evolve species into a higher level. War was very, not very often, at least the times I remember. But it came to an end because it just had to. But yes, as for your lifetimes, you were actually... That's strange. I'm not quite picking it up. You were actually on Venus as another species on Venus, a very tall being, humanoid, 7-8 foot, sometimes 9, somewhere 9 foot. This species was very rare on this planet. Sort of a... Yes, it's not a species they're quite familiar. It wasn't a Venus, it was another species. And it was like a species of knowledge from other galaxies.
Okay.
Bald. And they brought much knowledge to Venus.
Okay, we'll move on to another more short question. 2 days ago, around 1:35 p.m. of my time zone, I begin to think, to imagine if the gray type have a blackish color. And when I begin to imagine the gray type black, I see eyes like a reptilian bird. I put the light on him. He just hide in the black, and after he come back, he just feel something like more neutral energy.
And this is something that you saw in your room, or saw?
In my head.
In your head?
Yeah.
A reptilian bird? Yes. I
almost just see his eyes. You have many color around the eyes.
Let's see here. How does it connect with this energy? What is that? I believe it's a species from another planet, obviously, and it's connecting with you. It's a reptilian race. I do not believe you have a connection with this reptilian race.
Okay. Is a reptilian or is another kind? Dragon? Maybe dragon or...
Dragon. I feel more reptilian, but hybrid of reptilian and a bird species that I'm not too familiar with. It's a advanced civilization, has not made much room on this, has not visited this world too much. I feel that there's you've been receiving information about different species for a while, correct?
I don't know exactly what, but...
I believe they're contacting you to make themselves known.
Okay.
You're open to communication, so you're almost open to anybody coming through now.
It is his first contact for me, okay. And the last one is, before we begin the channeling, I show to Ivan a picture. Can you connect to this one?
And what is it that you want out of that?
Can you repeat what you say?
What is it that you want?
I show a picture to Ivan before we begin to channeling. White circle with some bar of color.
And what is it that you want to know about it?
What that representation, if that exists somewhere. The idea that come in my mind is a gray type unification.
Oh, a gray type of...
Many color.
A multicolor gray, you mean? Or a...
An unification of all... color of the gray type.
Kind of. That's... hopefully I'm understanding your question. Yes. One moment. Yes, I understand what you're talking about. One moment. I have to... Yes, there is much going on there. As for, there are many species connected to that creation that you have right there.
Yeah.
Not just one, several. And it's a symbol of their peace of mind, their knowledge, their... it's a way of communicating that right there. Not exactly, but close enough. It's sort of like a sign of peace. That's what that is.
Okay. I will receive more information about that later, so something like that.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Ad, please.
Hi, yes. It's Jenna again. I have a question with regard to the rumors of abductions, and is there any truth to the abduction theory that you abduct humans, and if so, do you keep them, and if you do keep them, what for what reason?
Well, I do not abduct, we do not abduct, well, but
no.
Some grays do, some, a small part of grays do, and some do still, because they don't know what they're doing. They think they're doing the right thing for themselves, and it's not benefiting anybody. Most of it's been stopped, but I believe some of them are still getting away with it. The reason they do it is to evolve their species, to help their DNA, and some of them do it to intimidate humans, to show them who's boss and who's more powerful. Some do, not all.
Negative ones, because
yeah.
I've heard that they have
right.
stopped
yes.
some time back.
Yes, they have stopped. But I believe that there are a few that are, they do still do it, but not the way they used to. They do attempt to do it still. So, but majority of it, like 99% of it has been stopped, yes. By other species that are positive, but yes. But some do get through the cracks, but not very often.
Mm-hmm. One quick question in the middle here, and I wanted to insert it. Why do so many people reincarnate in a certain planet so much? Like, for instance, Mark, he said 10 times in Mars. Why is that? Hasn't he been all over the place? Has he been to the rest of the planets, and that's why he chose Mars several times? I don't get that part.
why people reincarnate so many times on certain planets? Is that
yes.
What?
Yes. Have they been all over the other places, or they yes. just liked it? Just liked yes. it.
Many Martians reincarnated on your world after Mars sort of went away, you could say. Many Martians reincarnated on your planet. And that wasn't always for the better, because they remember their Martian lifetimes. And they would bring war, and just some wanted control. Many of them were very powerful, just to be dominant over others. Not all, but some.
Hunter or Alan?
Hello, Mama.
Hello.
I'm just wondering, what other species are you in contact with at the moment?
Yes, you're Gert Fichtner. The Galactic Federation of Light, of course. Positive Reptilians. Arcturians. At this point, we are observing, Venus is going through a transitional phase, so we are looking out for it right now, basically. There are not just, there's me and my counterparts on the ship, but there are several others that are monitoring Venus's, just to protect it, basically, from invaders. Just as your reptilian race, they like to move in and kick everybody out. Of course.
So have you had wars with them or something like that?
With reptilians, okay. Somewhat, yes.
Well,
not as brutal as some other wars that I am aware of. But we had wars, yes, but mild ones, not very violent ones. But yes.
And one last question: do I have a connection with you?
Venus life, Venus, I feel at least you had one lifetime on Venus. That's probably two, actually. As for connection with me personally, I do not believe so.
Okay, thank you.
Welcome. Hunter?
Yes, earlier, after you explained to me who these beings were around me, I was getting a lot of different sensations that I've been having lately, and I wasn't aware what they were. It's like a cold touch, it comes into my head on either the back right or the back left, and it's like real tingly, and it's just awkward. And can you tell me what that is?
I believe that's your spirit guide actually doing that.
What's the purpose of that?
Let you know that they're there to give you a sensation how close they really are, to get your attention. It's not your main guide, it's one of your guides. You have like three main guides, or three guides. I believe it's one of them that's part of doing that.
Like a deceased relative, by any chance?
Yes, I believe so.
Okay, thank you.
Yes.
Stephen?
Hello again.
Yeah.
I was wondering, how far is your ship physically from our planet? And also, whenever you finish with Ivan, I would love if you could hover or come over by my house and attempt to channel through me. I would just like to have that sensation to see where my capabilities are, if you're able to do that.
There is a chance of that. We are in Venus's orbit right now, so that's where we are right at the moment. That is possible. I cannot make any commitments, but that is possible to do that. There is a Martian entity that was not prepared to come through, but I think feels energy now.
Sweet. And do you have any connections with Dynamo? Dynamo on his Twitter page said he is a Martian also. I was wondering if he's part of your species or part of your area. His name's Dynamo. He's a magician.
As for the Mars, yes. As for Mars, yes. With Mars, correct. There are many Martians here.
Yes, I'm one of them. And one more question. When it refers to Mars, I heard that Mars destroyed their atmosphere, and before the planet got uninhabitable, they created a synthetic Merkaba, and as sort of like a portal, a vortice, and they basically teleported here to Earth. And they were, I believe, a negative type of species at that time. Is that somewhat true, or do you have any information on that?
Negative part of Mars, yes. There was Martians that were... yes. Not all Mars was negative, of course. Only a small group. Power hungry. Even actually part of that government was corrupt. And they sort of did their own thing. And as I scan this one's mind, because I know there's many questions about the Greys and Mars, and what's the whole story on that, because there's stories about such as Mars being, one second, taken over by the Greys. There's a war between the Martians and the Greys. That is correct. There was a war. As for breeding, inbreeding, there was supposed to be an inbreeding between a Grey, Zeta Grey, and a Martian queen. That is correct, but that is not why Mars went. There was several... Mars became very toxic in its later years. There was, in some ways, this small group was becoming dangerous to other species in the universe, actually. They left the planet. And on Mars, they were sort of, you can say, they're planning on attacking Earth in many ways. So that was one of the reasons of their demise, through war. So.
Sweet, thank you.
Yes.
I was wondering, could you tell if I got any more Arcturian infusions? Last time I checked, I was at 28%, supposedly. I was just wondering if you could see.
I do not believe there's a change there. I believe it's still the same.
All right, sweet. Thanks. What was that?
I believe you're also tapping into that energy, and you're learning how to use it.
Yeah, sweet. Also, there's this new being that said he's from a race that like no one really knows about yet, and he said he might give me infusions. And I was just wondering if those started yet. Like, can you tell if I have any infusions of like an unknown race to the Earth?
Who are you? Yeah, it's a race that wishes to be. One moment. I cannot be completely sure, but I believe that it's Palladian. I believe it's a tall white.
Okay, cool.
So it is, they are known here, but not, you know, they make themselves unknown usually.
All right, sweet, thank you.
You're welcome.
Anybody else?
I got one more question.
No, you take my part. Hold on. Regarding so many things, how can you guys really tap on our energy and see our DNA being increased? And how can you tap at every planet as soon as, just like that? How do you look at us? You know, you're tapping it everywhere spontaneously. How do you do this?
Really, it's psychic energies, psychic psychic powers.
And what density are you in?
Fourth density right now.
So by being at the fourth density, we will be like you guys?
Yes. Oh, yes, of course.
Wait, I'm looking forward to that. It's beautiful.
Yes, much anxious. Yes, I believe you are on your way. Yes.
You know, I've got chills right now. God, tell me. So what is my connection with you, of course? I haven't asked that question. With you in person and your other planet?
On Venus, what your connection was on Venus?
Yes.
I believe you had two lifetimes there.
I didn't like it, though. It means that two lifetimes, that means not much, was it?
Not necessarily. It might. But the whole thing about that is those lifetimes were enough knowledge for you to... There was no need to keep going there.
Yeah, I'd love to explore. I'd love to go...
Yes, and I believe...
To places.
I believe you were there during its end of times also. So that was another reason why you had short lifetimes there, or two lifetimes, because it was closing up for shop, or however you want to call that.
So what about this... can you tap on my DNA? Has been increased also, because I asked for... more infusions.
Do you have one that you want?
I wanted the Pleiadians, I wanted Lyran, and I wanted Acturians. Hathor is there. I don't mind Hathor.
I'm not sure what your... I can't... your Acturian, whatever it was before, I feel like a slight increase there.
Uh-huh. So, can you see the percentage? Can you see the percentage?
No, I cannot see that.
Okay, I got your point. Then you have to be in group near in order to tap on it correctly.
Yes, right. Because you are being protected. Yes, that is
beautiful. Beautiful. I see your question. One more question. I had this today in my mind. I recalled a distant cousin of mine that had a Down syndrome, kind of retarded. So he died in a small age. He was in his still a small kid. But I remembered him when he was in his seat, he was looking at me at a gaze before he died, about 2 or 3 days before he died. So I was wondering, what is he looking at my energy or what? Because he was staring at me, gazing at me all the time. Him and my grandmother also, before she died, the same thing. They were gazing at me in a weird way, even though we were all in a big group, but they were looking at me only. So what they were looking at, I wasn't sure.
Only thing I can pick up from that is that they're noticing you have many beings around you.
Uh-huh, because they were weird. They were looking in a weird way, you know, like, they're what's going on?
Because they can tell that you have, they might not be able to completely understand it,
yeah.
But they notice that there is many energies around you watching over you.
So they before they die, they can see all that.
Yes, correct.
I see. Okay.
That is strange. Okay. Yes, that's.
Can you see the beings? Can you see the beings? Pleiadian.
Yes. Oh, strangely enough, here I'll tell you this.
Go ahead.
It's very. We see things a little bit differently than others. Others.
You see different.
Yes, I see a giraffe being behind you. Are there giraffes at all? Because there's one watching you right now.
Wow.
Very friendly.
Benevolent one. Great. Benevolent ones. Because I'm the type that love soft entities like angels and dolphins and butterflies. So when you talk about dragons and things, I go, oh my God, I freak out, you know?
But this is a giraffe species.
Giraffe? Giraffe, you said?
Giraffe, yes.
Uh-huh, we'll talk about that one day. Okay, yes. We'll have it through Evan. I hope so. Thank you very much.
Yes, because many species are... Because I'm not your normal guest through this vessel, so I see other beings than what you're used to.
Uh-huh, beautiful. Yes, beautiful. Do you have anything personal with you? Any connection with you in person, Marla?
Connection with me? That is a good question.
Yeah.
Yes. Probably.
Good.
maybe not a very close one, but yes, I believe through conversation.
The last two times I had been there. Okay. That sounds good, because I like your energy. You're quite fine. You're beautiful. Thank you very much. Who's next, Stephen?
Yeah, I just had a quick question. I was wondering, are you able to tap into like all of the lives that we lived here on Earth? And if you could, like, or is there a way you can estimate like how many thousands, hundred thousands, like a sum it all up of how many lives I was here on Earth? Is there a way you can tap?
Yes, but I feel I am being permitted to do so. Understand, when the time is right, that will come through. It seems that it's good to live with some mystery at this point.
Exactly.
I am not the one to do that. There are others that are to do that. Let's go with that one.
All right, thank you. And do I have any entities around me that wish to send me a message? Or you see any different ones, or other than that frog one?
That frog one, he's like a brother to you from another lifetime.
All right.
I guess you guys are very close, but this is from a long time ago. I believe he will come through eventually, also. To say hi, at least.
Sweet, thank you. Much love.
Hello, Mala.
Yes.
Can you see the entities that are around me at the moment?
A friendly reptilian.
Cool.
A Palladian. And a Wyrian also. Actually, a male Wyrian.
What is the male Lyran's role? Who is
he? He's there to watch your back right now.
Okay.
You know, he looks like a lion, but he's not a lion. He's a Lyran. But he has hair around him, but similar, not the same.
Have they got any message for me? Anything?
Only one moment. Only thing, this is from the Wyrian, he says to be careful who you are friends with. There is suspicious figures around you, I guess. Does that make any sense to you?
Yeah, kinda.
Kinda, yes. I feel kinda, that sounds about right. I think they're being a little bit overprotective, but that's okay. But there are some shady individuals that are around you, and they wish for you not to be associated with them. But I think you would already know that.
Yeah.
So, anyway.
Thank you for that. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Pat?
Yes.
Hi, Marla. I just have a question with regard to where you live. Is there, like, any kind of political structure? If so, what is it? How does it go? Is there a government there? How is that?
Oh, yes, but we're very neutral. We have discussions all the time. We are similar to your Greek, ancient Greece political system. I'm not sure if you're familiar with that, but we are a loving race. We're not negative such as yours, but that's not... Anyway, of course, your government has many agendas, but we're not going to go there. We're just a positive race to bring knowledge to us and to others that it will benefit. And we observe Earth. We do not really interact with it. But we are sister. This is our sister planet in many ways. So we are... Some of us are interacting with, but on a more of a observing manner. So we have loved ones on your world right now. Obviously, it's a reincarnation that we keep an eye on if they need our assistance. Hopefully that helps. But yes, our government is very plain Jane, as you call it. We're just We're good folks that are trying to unite the universe in a positive way.
And I just have one more quick question.
Yes.
Do you feel any entities around me as well?
Archangel Gabriel, I feel his energies. An Arcturian, male. And a reptilian that is somewhat friendly. I think he's keeping an eye on you. As for this, what this reptilian is doing, I think he's just there as observation. He's not doing anything, as far as I'm concerned.
Okay. Thank you.
I probably should be going now. Is there anything else?
Check.
Yes.
I was wondering if you could connect with a dream or probably an experience I had with this one being. I heard he's a newly spiritual being named Sirion the Shade. And I was very powerful, and I just had a meeting with him, and his eyes glowed bright white when I met him at the door, and he took me into his car, and we went somewhere. I don't know where we went. Do you have any info on that experience?
And he gave you this name, correct?
Yes. Oh,
I
got a channel through a person, Sirion the Shade. He believe he's like a representative of the shade in the dark, the shade energy. But he's like a positive. He's a positive, newly spiritual species or group or something. And he just met me at the door. He knocked on the door and I went. And his eyes started glowing really bright white. He was in all black. And then we went to his car and we started driving. And I asked him where we were going, and he didn't say anything. And I woke up, I think, at that time.
Oh, that's fascinating. Yes, he's giving you knowledge from his world, his perspective. Every once in a while, you receive downloads from him, but you might not be too sure where it came from. And that is what many of your downloads are coming from him. I believe, and there's much he's given you that you have not quite discovered yet to understand it, to be verbal about it. So, such as you have knowledge within you that is, some of it is actually secret knowledge that will be used in the future. So, such as your, like a spiritual center, I believe you spoke about.
Yes.
Yes, that was much from his collective. Yes, so that was an idea from his. So, of course, there's other species a part of that, but he was definitely one of them. So, this is just to spread the love across the world.
Yes, yes, definitely. Thank you much.
We have Marco. He wants to ask also, if possible.
Yes.
Can you ask Marco?
Yes, hello.
Yeah.
Yes.
Thank you. I have a question about a sister that I may have that already from another life. Yesterday, Elvis the Reptilian told me that I have a soul with me that is a sister for me. I was wanted to ask if this is true, if it is really my sister from another life.
Yes. The sister from another lifetime that's watching over you.
Can I get a name?
Of course, she's very delicate, very quiet. I believe some of your quiet nature comes through her. I believe you have that. Some of that is from her. Gabrielle is the name she gives me.
Gabriella?
Yes, Gabriel, same thing, yes.
Okay, thank you. And did I have a time life with your species too?
On Venus, yes. Once again, I feel two lifetimes. And that's the number two seems pretty big in this group. Two lifetimes. at near the, once again, near the end of our life cycle, or Venus's life cycle, yeah.
Okay, thank you.
I believe you're an engineer.
Okay, Marla, I've got one before you leave also. If you're interested in Grytviknir in our human colony, and if you want to be a member there as the rest of the our stars' friends, so what do you do? Do you apply for being there, a member to be with them, or what do you do? How does it go on? How do you do the procedure?
Our species is... I feel we are unprepared for that type of arrangement at this time. We have agendas on our planet right now that we are attending to. But as for connecting with Grytviknir, I don't believe we have communicated in that way to join their collective. But I don't, at this point it seems, I don't believe that they have so much going on over there right now. I'm not sure if you want to be involved with all that, but I don't think we can even handle the tasks that they handle. We have enough.
I see. I was just saying, suggesting if you have the interest, yes, to apply, ask to Kurt.
Yes, in many ways, yes. We have a conversation with them, and we make an alliance with them. That's how that works. We join forces, as you say. But I'm not sure if we have the manpower for that. But we do send energies to your world during its weather seasons and all that, definitely. To positive energies to your world to keep it from your weather from tearing your world apart.
Yeah. Sounds good. Do you have a language, a galactic language, that we can hear a blessing from your side? If possible.
And real quick, Marco wanted to know that his sister was the same race planet that he lived with. Were they on the same planet, or same race that his sister, that they lived together?
I believe that was on Earth lifetime. I don't believe it was a alien lifetime that he's thinking it might be. Oh, actually, that's false. Yes, they did have a lifetime on an alien. I believe Palladian lifetime they had together. But they actually had a white Earth lifetime also.
Thank you.
Yes.
Does your galactic language sound like?
We just going to sound like some of the other ones that you've heard.
Just similar, okay.
One moment.
I forgot to ask you, in what aspect can you help us as our human colony? What's your tick? What are you good at?
Oh, yes, to bring positive energies into a negative environment. We are very familiar of your reptilian race and their cleverness. And we have figured out ways to outsmart them.
Great. So,
yes, we've also created technologies to... what's a good word here? But to
elevate. Say,
yes. Mm-hmm. To lock them out or lock them away from bothering her race. So, yes, they're very clever. They adapt very fast, but we have found ways around their techniques. Of course, they're always evolving, but so are we. So, mm-hmm. We're helpful in that regard to keep unfriendly visitors from... Because you are all protected, definitely. And, you know, extra protection, you can never have too much.
So. Great. So I'll ask you for that. You're playing the part of Grindel then and Elvis.
In many ways, yes.
Great.
Of course,
good.
We're also galactic teachers.
Uh-huh. Great.
Back to your languages and also...
Channeling?
channeling. Yes.
Beautiful. But more than elevating, teleporting.
Teleporting, yes.
Okay, you've got all the solutions then. Okay, that's what we're looking for.
Well, to connect to other species to understand them, because understand when you go into a fourth density, you're going to be seeing many species, and sometimes you need certain entities like us to help introduce you to them to understand what you're dealing with. Because there's many, many, many species out there that you're not going to understand when you first get into this.
Kind of like the Green Lantern, when they have all of them different species where together on the planet.
Yes, correct. As for a galactic language to go through this one, I am not able to download one. It'd be one I've already heard, probably.
It's okay. You've done enough. Thank you very much. Well appreciated.
Much love to all of you.
Thanks. Any connection with you will be appreciated.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good evening to you.
Thank you. Much appreciated. Greetings, everyone. I am the Martian that was going to come in earlier, but I got busy. You may call me... Yes, correct. You can call me Ajax.
Ajax.
I am not on Mars, but I am a Martian. I am not permitted on my own planet because of...
Wait a minute. What's the difference between Martians and Mars? Isn't it the same thing? Well,
yeah.
Martians, aren't they are the same.
I am on Mars, yes, but I am not allowed on my planet.
Get you, okay.
Yes, I am a Martian species. Many of us are still out in the universe because we are not always... Some of us are in orbit with Mars, but not always, because we are not permitted because of your elites have stolen our planet, as far as I'm concerned. There are...
And you look at... Finish.
Yes, go ahead. No.
I was asking about your physique. You look like Marla, exactly the same, bit taller maybe because you're male.
Yes, bald-headed, red.
Ah, you're red and she's blue.
Yes, but I am a Martian. Okay. She was from Venus. I am from Mars. Understand that.
I get that now. Okay, fine.
Yes. Yes, we know much about your situation. Oh, yes, and such as your site-to-site situation. Yes, we know much about that. That's ridiculous in our mind. Yes, your government can't be trusted no matter what, as far as I'm concerned. And within your government, there are nothing but narcissistic cross-dressers. That is my thinking on it. They are... greedy and lost within their own power.
So when do you feel that we're going to get a welcome, nice to meet you? And that's pretty cool that y'all actually transferred from entity to entity. That's actually the first time like he kind of did that, where he just one came in and one left and came in without taking a break. That's pretty awesome.
Well, and yes.
Expanding.
Yes, I was around and it's like, yeah, sure. Let me ride through. He has enough energy at this point.
What do you feel about site to site? When do you feel it's very
I believe it's very beneficial. I believe it'll help you connect to the universe, and I think that's wonderful. Of course, your governments see that and want nothing, no part of that, because they're a bunch of narcissistic, you know what. And your much of that, yes, is part of the reptilian race that has a hold on your planet. Your elite wants nothing to do with site to site. They want to get rid of it altogether. Want you to just join the pact and forget about site to site altogether. As for compromise and things like that, that is undecided. Of course, you're probably very well aware of that. But I also believe that some of you have already done site to site. And I don't believe it was illegal at all, but I believe site to site is going on, just you might not be fully aware of that.
Yeah, Jason definitely has.
Yes, some have made it through legally. I don't believe there was a chip involved either. And as for this whole chip nonsense, it is nonsense. Jeez, what a bunch of...
It's another way to control us, but we are out of it.
Yes, but let me see if I can tap into your what is the outcome of that? I believe they're not let go of that because they're just... They're so corrupt, it's beyond words. I believe some they'll let go without a chip, but most they want a chip because they want control, they want to spy on you, etc. As for an ending to this, because I believe there will be, eventually they'll give this up. I believe in the future, not now, because now they're... I'm trying to help you guys out here, because this is ridiculous.
This.
I believe after compromise, where they say, yes, we're going to put chips in people, blah, 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 after that, they're going to realize it's not very beneficial and only make it to a few that they do not trust, that they feel that will not return. There are some, then they already know who they are. Those that want to do site to site and not come back to your planet at all. Those are the ones I feel that they will... They're the ones that are going to be microchipping later on.
They want to agree to it. The ones who want to leave the planet Earth.
Yes, there are those, even probably in your colony and not in your colony, that want to do that. Yeah, your government's not very trustworthy, that's for sure.
Yeah, plus we put them in power, not the other way around. Our constitutional right... supports our inherent unalienable rights. I mean, we got these God-given rights at birth. We put them in power, and they're just abusing their power, basically.
Yes.
Ajax, whose idea was it, the chip, in the first place? Our government or from the space friends?
Reptilians.
Oh, my God. Forget it. Of course.
Of course. Who else? Which is chip them all and get it over with. Yeah, they know how you guys operate. They know you wouldn't like that, so that's why they want to do it. So then it'll discourage you from doing site to site.
They're just blocking the matter. They're blocking the whole thing. They want to block it and delay it. And okay.
I believe there is a chance for compromise, but yeah, because they want to keep a hold on this world more than anything. There are other races that are getting involved with this. Syrians, because they don't want this to... You can say joining the conversation to hopefully make this whole chip thing go away.
All right. Beautiful.
Fascinating.
So your role is just like Marla to push them away, those reptilians from us. Or is it something different?
Stay away from them because we know we're not to pick a fight with them. Yes, many of them are underground. Many of them are on Mars, of course, being bullies. starting wars for no reason so they can dominate everything. There are mantis over there that they control. Greys and reptilians at this point, as far as I'm concerned, do not get along with each other. I'm talking about the negative greys. The negative greys think they are pretty tough without, you know, they can do their own thing without them. So hopefully that, I'm just throwing things out. Help you guys out. Give you an idea of what's going on.
Hello there, how are you? It's Sarah.
Oh, greetings.
They said your name is Ajax?
Yes.
Hello, Ajax.
Greetings.
Thank you for coming. Is there anything specifically you would like to tell us? Anything on your mind?
Oh, thank you. Yes. Of course, your elites are running scared right now. They do not like the sight to sight. That's not news to you. I believe your ascension process is in. It's in a good. It's in good shape. It's slow, but going in a good direction. Your elites are realizing they are losing their grip. Slowly, many more will wake up. This is nothing new, probably to you guys, but news, and not just information, but feelings. Many people around the world, your Earth, are feeling this isn't right. There's got to be more going on than just what we're being told. So they're being guided out of their hold or matrix sleep or however you want to word that. So your elites are very aware of this, and they of course do not like that. That's why they're doing this whole site to site thing to block it, because they know if they let it go, everybody's going to do a site to site, and that'll be the end of it. So they have to stop it the best they can. I don't believe they're going to always, this whole chipping thing. I don't think it's going to last forever. It will be for a while because you're just starting it, but I don't think it's going to be forever. They're going to give up eventually.
Why are they trying to prevent site to site? Like, what happens when a human goes site to site?
Well, it benefits them. It gives them knowledge about their galactic friends. Gives them power to touch within their energies. You know, to
become. Okay, okay, sweet. So, what you're saying, like. Because you don't really remember it, so when you go site to site, you come back and you're just changed a bit?
Yeah.
That's what they're afraid of?
I don't always be fully aware of it, but you do change.
Yes, all right.
They don't like that at all, yes.
All right, sweet, thank you.
Anything that benefits you guys, they don't want anything to do with. You understand that. You probably know that.
Steven?
Probably a bunch.
Yes, I was wondering, I have a question. I went to the hospital not probably like a month.
Yes.
Go ahead.
Sorry about that. I was just going to say I went to hospital and because I was feeling sick, my stomach and everything, probably about 5 or 6 months ago, and they took 4 vials of blood from me, and I asked them why they did that. They took literally four, and they didn't really tell me why. I just wondered, did they use that blood for any reasons that were not for the purpose of me being at that hospital, and have they ever used any of my blood for any nefarious reasons?
One second, let's see. I do not believe so. At this point, I don't think they knew what they were doing. That's a feeling I have. I don't believe they're using it for anything. No, they just. Miscommunication, they're just being stupid.
Sweet, I'll allow healing from you if you can. Thank you.
Yes. Anything else? You want to? Oh, yes. If there's no questions.
Go ahead.
Yes, you're elite. In my opinion, they're a bunch of cross-dressing, narcissistic egomaniacs. They have so much power, they've gone insane. But I think you've already know that. They are insecure. They do not wish to lose their power, such as that movie, the Ant movie. That just popped in my mind. There's an Ant movie, it's an animated movie about you know, the few, and then all the other people go against them and destroy the ones at the top of the pyramid. That's what they're afraid of. They actually made films of their fears, because they control Hollywood, etc. Many of your movies have messages in them, not for you, but for others, and also to brainwash whoever they can brainwash into a certain mentality, such as your 007. Yes, that is part of the Illuminati in many ways. That's what many of them think themselves as, is a narcissistic playboy that can do no wrong. And many of your elite are like that. They think they are, at least. And that's probably one of the reasons why that's still going on. Not just for money reasons, for ego reasons. So hopefully that was entertaining. Anything, any questions, anything?
Hello.
I've got a question.
Sorry. Is it okay to go, or does someone have a question?
Go ahead.
Okay. I understand that I have a reptilian past life. Should I feel ashamed, from what I've heard about the reptilians, should I feel ashamed in any way to have had a reptilian past life? That's what I'm trying to get at.
No, I don't believe so. That was to help you become a stronger person, help you become more complicated, actually. Becoming more... Reptilians, they do have their you know, they're good and they're bad. Become more acceptable to different races. They can give you knowledge to help you adapt to different environments, to help you survive certain environments, such as this world. So, yeah, I don't think it was...
So it's important to see both sides of the coin, so to speak.
Correct. And it's, yeah. Of course, their lifetime isn't easy, but you survived it well.
Oh, cheers. Thank you for that. Thank you.
Hi, yes. Ajax, nice to meet you. My name is Jenna. I have a quick question. Can you tell me, or tell us, rather, what... From your perspective, what goes on at Area 51? Can you expand on what we've kind of rumors and what we've heard? Is there anything that you can divulge to us about that?
Yes. Of course, your elites. Yes, the rumors are true. There is underground bases there. And that Area 51 is just very popular because of the leaks from other scientists that just got tired of what was going on. It's not just Area 51. There are other bases that are very similar. They just don't have the attention that one does. Yes, gray technology, Palladian technology is there also. They made a deal with the Palladians, as far as I'm concerned, negative ones, and they somehow made a deal to get... I'm not sure how they did that, but they found a way to make a deal with that. Reptilians have technology, but they only keep it to their elite. They don't let the military... because they use their technology against everybody, whatever they feel like. Area 51, mostly gray technology, Palladians, underground usually. Some grays are still associated with this. Many of them... Let's say that some of them are okay, but others do not trust... You know, wonder why. Don't trust your government at all and kind of sick of them. Some of them play game, practical jokes on their governments because they're just sick and tired. That's where you have your men in black to go after them sometimes. They even mess around with men in black on many occasions, actually, because they're just tired of the lies from your government. It's just one lie after the other. You can't trust them, period. Of course, the gray technology was re-engineered, or however you call that, backward engineered, however, but they still needed the gray's help to run this technology because they didn't quite understand it. Yes, operations are still going on right now. Much of California actually is used as, there are sightings there of military aircraft that look alien-like, that is... Yeah, they like going through Edwards Air Force Base is one place they like. But yeah, much testing is done in Area 51. Of course, that's general, but yeah, most of it's done underground. Hopefully, I answered that correctly.
Well, thank you. Thank you. That was very insightful. Thank you.
Anything else?
I have one more question, if that's okay.
Yes.
Is there other Area 51s scattered across our world?
Yes.
And how many? Do you know how many?
I don't have a number, but every country, major country, has them. Russia, they have a few. India, China.
UK?
UK, there's a lot of population there. If it's not...
What about the Arabic world also? Finish your question, your answer.
What was that?
What about the Arabic world?
Yes.
So they're everywhere?
Pretty much. Mm-hmm. The reptilian bases are underground. Many reptilians are running these bases. But mostly Illuminati groups. Illuminati has different sections of their groups, so it's spread out, so they're part of that. It's all black projects. Mostly the control center is really around the United States. United States runs the rest of the world, far as I can tell. So they're the ones in charge of the alien activity, mostly. So if there's a sighting, you probably have heard of this. If there's a sighting, the Men in Black go there. It's not other countries. Men in Black or your black projects go there. United States connected goes there. Because they're a bunch of narcissistic cross-dressers, so...
What's with you in this idea of cross-dressing?
That's what they are. I am just telling you... They do not like this. That is their problem. They know where they are.
Okay.
They have so much... They have all this power, and they just... They lose their minds and become...
Cross-dressers.
Yeah. They change their genders. They do all these things. They change it two or three times. They have the money. They can do it. They have the technology to do it.
If they want to cross-dress, let them, you know?
I agree. I don't have a problem with that, but I'm just letting you know who you're dealing with. That's
okay.
I'm not joking.
Michael, can I answer something? Just before Sarah goes for the question, can you drink while you're channeling? Because he hasn't drank, Ivan hasn't drank before.
Oh, yes, I don't know.
You drink. Can you do that?
I don't see a drinking substance here, so it's...
Okay, it's going to have to wait then.
Okay.
If there was discomfort here, I would be leaving.
He's okay. Okay, great.
Perfect. Marco has a question. He would like to know, if it is possible for our friendly galactic family to show themselves to him in the skies. Like maybe a spaceship or. And Steven as well.
Yeah, so do that when the time is right for them. Yes, they have to be careful when you do this.
Mm-hmm.
I believe that will. When the time is right, I believe that will happen.
What is your role on Mars?
Well, technically, I haven't been on Mars for such a long time. If I had a role, I'd be with technology, like a technician.
Okay.
But seeing how I'm on my ship, we are currently observing your Earth and speaking to other species and speaking to other Martians to spread our knowledge of what is going on, to send our love to your world, of course, and to our knowledge of our planet, to those that... See, right now, Mars is untouchable. As far as I'm concerned, it has been taken over. As for any its negative forces are around it. As for positive, I believe they have to leave that alone at this point. They have no control over it. Some Palladians are speaking to them, but more of your elites have control over it. They believe that this is their home now. Many of your elites, you're top of your pyramid. That is where many of them reside. So they have their own government there. They have their own collectives, such as slaves. There is a human colony there, but they're not exactly happy about it. Some do live a normal life, some don't.
I had a dream some time ago about human slaves somewhere.
You believe it's on Mars?
I have no idea where it was. I just know that I was there and I was able to escape, but then I went back for the people to help them to realize that they could escape because it wasn't that many guards, but the guards, their faces didn't look quite right. And they were quite mean, like very mean. And the people had on these gowns and kind of like a grayish brownish gowns.
But they were from your planet, correct? Or you think it was
they looked human. They all looked human, but there was something wrong with the guard's face.
I believe it was a past life on Earth, but as for that guard's face, I believe there was a reptilian control over that one, or several of them.
Yeah, all of them.
Yes. I believe it was during ancient times. I do not have a direct connection.
Ancient because there was a gate, like our gates here.
Oh, like recently?
These look like fences.
Fences as in your modern fences?
Our modern fences, yes.
Okay.
And like, if you were to imagine a fence in at a jail or a prison, more of that nature.
Okay, one second.
Interesting. I don't feel you when you're reading me.
I'm trying to read that situation. And probably because I'm not reading anything. I'm trying to see what exactly. I felt an ancient time, but I must be reading something else with that. But for your modern situation, I might not be the right one to be.
That's okay if you're not finding it, but. But I just wanted to know if that was on Mars.
I believe it was on your world.
It was here on Earth? Oh, okay.
I don't see any Martian. As for slaves, yes, we do have slaves there. I do not believe that. I think it was on your planet. That's all I have for that. Sorry.
Thank you.
Quick question.
Yes.
Could you give us a name of species that we have not here yet?
One moment. Let's see what we have here. Anybody would like to raise their hand to be known? There are other species, but they wish not to be made themselves too aware. Oh, yes, there's a raccoon species, but I imagine you're very somewhat aware of that.
Yeah.
Where is that one?
And the giraffe now.
And the giraffe as well.
How did I arrive at that? Is that what you said?
The giraffe.
No, the giraffe. Yes, that one has a connection with you.
With which one?
Giraffe.
Giraffes are technology. They're pretty advanced with technology. They are very advanced with that, but primitive as for their culture. They're very simple.
Mm-hmm.
They're very simplistic, which is
good. They have a connection with Noha?
Yes.
Yeah, she's hanging around with me. She's hanging with me. That's what he said.
Yes.
I mean, the lady said before.
I'm not sure if they're ready for contact like this.
Be ready for contact, you said?
Yes, through channels, I believe they're not ready, such as... Yeah, I believe there's a horse one that tried to come through here.
Oh my goodness, I love this so much.
Yes, I love horses! Yes.
They are...
Steven has a question.
They have to talk them into it. But yes, go ahead.
Okay, we'll ask.
Hey, I was just wondering about the raccoon species. Could you ask for them, so have we shooken the bag enough yet?
Yes, in many ways. They are curious to be known. They're not scared in any way. They're just not sure if we're ready for it.
Right, right. They're very, very, very intelligent. And last time I heard about them, they didn't want to make contact with us yet because they felt we wouldn't evolve or we haven't shaken the bag enough. And also, I had a raccoon that came into my garage a couple times and ate our cat's food. I was wondering, I would love to meet with that raccoon, and you know, because they're kind of scared. They're really scared. And if you could send a message to that, if they could send a message to that raccoon, see if he'll meet with me. He comes in. I've seen him a couple times, maybe two of them, that comes into my garage and eats the cat food and stuff, and even opened this little metal lid because I heard it fall on the ground.
They're smart, yeah. Very intelligent, yes. I can send him a message, but I'm not sure if they'll listen.
Thank you.
That should be them. Yes.
Any message for me?
You're bald, correct?
I what?
You don't have
any. Yes. It's bald.
That is the way to go, yes. Everybody approves of that.
My head? You mean my head?
Yes, all your galactic friends approve of that.
yeah, they can see through now.
Yes.
Okay, thanks all. And do exist a blackish gray type?
Yes.
Positive?
Some are.
Do you have a name and symbol?
This is quite common. A triangle, of course. That is common with other species, though. They're very telepathic, of course. Some are negative. Some can't be trusted. But there are a group that can be at times.
Do the positive and negative use the same symbol?
I believe so, yes.
No difference between both sides?
I mean, the negative more uses a gold, and the positive uses more of a white.
Okay, no name for...
name, well, you can call it a white-gray, or a black. I mean, there is a white-gray among them. That is more of the positive ones. There's a white and a black. Black is more...
Okay. Because we got the golden, the silver spark. That's why I watch if they have a specific name.
Oh, okay, let's see here. I don't believe they wish to be contacted. They're giving me name of like a. There might be a. I don't think it's a race. Scion. Well, they're calling themselves the Scion race.
Scion.
Scion. Scion.
Scion.
Scion.
S-I-O-N.
Yes.
They are positive.
There's actually a black race and a white race, and they're pretty much the same. The white ones are positive.
Okay. They are mixed. Thanks. We'll let you close.
Regarding the raccoons now, the raccoons you were talking, something came up to my mind. There's a raccoon-like entity that's in the desert without the stripes. I don't know the name of it, though. It looks like a raccoon, but without the stripes. I find it so intriguing and looks like a human, you know, like the way it reacts is exactly like human beings. What is it? Is it there? Or what is it called? I don't know. So I'm so, I want this kind of entity to come through.
Well, yes, they're very intelligent.
They are. They look like humans to me, you know. I
are
see
you talking
them.
About mini cats?
No. I'm talking about a raccoon entity like.
Awesome.
Mm-hmm. I have more to say, but I probably should get going.
Yes, okay. Yeah, I felt it from the beginning.
One more, Marco had a question, and his question is there any race in this universe or others that are more advanced than the Draconian race?
Orions are more advanced. Andromedans have more advanced technology. Even some of the Greys do. So, see, it's not always about the technology, but the Draconians are just, their technology isn't always more advanced, but just they are more deceptive than other races. And others aren't, so it's deceptive. So that's why they have an advantage. It's hard to, now they understand them more than anything, but before they did not quite understand how a race can be like this, but anyway. I think I have overstayed my stay.
Thank you. Thank you so much. We love you.
Well appreciated, Ajax.
Do not worry about you, sir. We got.
Thanks. Welcome to be here.
Thank you. Don't worry about your Illuminati or a bunch of sissies. So I think you can. We're coming up on time, so.
That's good to hear.
We welcome you anytime here.
Yes. Thank you.
What's your glass of water, Ivan?
Oh, I gotta go get it.
This guy was willing to drink, but he didn't find the glass.
Yeah, I never forgot to bring it up.
Which is good. I like that part.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I'll be back.
So, I missed the whole beginning. Was there another being before this one?
Yeah, Lady Marla.
Lady Marla?
She's Marla from... I just called her Lady. Her name is Marla from Venice. Venus.
Oh, Venus! Oh, wow.
Yes, and she's blue in color, which is surprising.
What's that?
Blue in color, which is surprising for me.
Oh.
So, she's like the Pleiadians, you know? She looks
right.
Like that. And she lives in a ship.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I thought all the time she was from Mars, but this guy who came in, Ajax, said no, he's Martian and she's Venetian. Which is news.
I thought they looked like humans, the Venetians.
They look like
really, really tall humans.
Palladian-like, you know, humans with hair, they're without hair.
Right, but wasn't there some Venetians who came to visit Earth around the 50s?
Like so
the
was
40s
one
and 50s? And they looked human, but they were just very tall.
In the 50s?
Yeah.
I didn't hear 51 you're talking about. They weren't tall.
No. Hmm. Apparently, there were some Venetians who came to visit our presence. They visited JFK and they visited, Eisenhower.
Oh, Eisenhower is another story. But she went to them. They didn't visit her. They took her there.
Some people, I believe, in Italy said they met some Venetians there as well.
Oh, okay. Don't know about that. What are you up to, Ivan?
Yeah, if you want to do another one.
Galaxus or Orion?
I'm just wondering, is it possible to channel God himself?
Guns.
Interesting.
Guardian self? Our guardian self?
No, God.
God, no. I don't believe those people when they say they're channeling God. I don't get it. You know what I mean?
Why not?
I don't know.
Within you?
It's just like a piece of them. It's not like the whole thing. Like God says, Brian says he's like a piece.
It's like every one of us is a piece of God.
Okay, and well, I've got a piece of it inside us. The idea doesn't sink in. I don't know. From my background, the baby.
Does God have an oversoul that watches over it? I don't know. I'm confused.
Let's see what Ivan has.
Well, the founders, I guess that's kind of, I don't know.
Yeah. You want to try a catfish?
Yeah.
Come on. You are somewhere. I don't know where exactly.
From one extreme,
let's try the horse. Let's try the horse, the one he said that.
Maybe
the
Amarant technology.
You try a horse or someone from Orion?
Yes.
Yeah, that would be nice.
Beautiful. Let's go. Yeah, pray for him and let's give you blessings.
Why, howdy, all.
Hello there.
I am that horse species you're trying to get a hold of.
Oh hello. Howdy there to you.
Hello.
It's you from my country.
Where are you from? On our Earth or somewhere else?
Somewhere else.
Humanoid?
Correct. That's a whole different story there.
Okay.
You can call me. You can call me Lucas.
Lucas, nice good. To meet you, Lucas.
Hey, Lucas.
Yes. Say that again.
I was just saying my son's called Lucas. That's a bit of a coincidence. Nice. Means
connecting. Bear with me. Oh, what a lovely world. Yes. We usually don't deal with your world too much. We sort of just put our horses there, our species there, and just took off. Just, you know, talk to you guys later when you guys are ready to speak to us. But seeing how you're ready to speak to us, we were kind of hesitant, but now here we are.
No. Nice. We love you so much. We love you so much. How can you be hesitant? God, you're adorable entities.
Yes, we are. Yes, correct. What was that?
I was just saying, even human colony, we embrace you. We embrace everyone that comes through.
Thank you.
That's okay.
Do you have a main message you wish to give to us?
Oh, a message that we are thankful for this communication. You doing this is quite fascinating to us. This is quite new. Not many really called to us. And so our hesitation was like, are they serious? They really want to.
Of course. Talk to Come you. On.
As for our race, we are kind of hippie-ish. We do like music. We are a friendly bunch. We are. Family is our collective. Music is our thing, and we connect with your, of course, our species on your world to help you connect to each other, obviously, through travel.
So tell us how you look like exactly. You have a head of a horse or a head of a human being? What does it look like?
Head of a horse.
Head of a horse. Because in the old history, there was a figure of a head of a human being and the body of a horse, the vice versa. So do you want to do one or another difference?
Yes.
Which one is which? I wanted to know that. The head of a horse and a body of a human.
That is myth. One second. No, we are horse heads and humanoid bodies. They do exist, as for the head of the...
Human.
Yes.
Okay.
I'm not connecting to that, but...
They're not your brothers?
Not necessarily. We don't really have conversations with them every day. We don't have tea with them, if that's what you're wondering.
So you've been to the Egyptian civilization because your entity like was there, wasn't it?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, much was, yeah, you know, we were expecting so much. We were expecting your world to evolve into this paradise and join the galactic family. And, of course, that was not to be. We became very close at that point.
Do you have an affinity for country music, like our country music?
Yes.
Because you just said howdy. I'm like, wow.
Yes, we're a bunch of hippies.
That's very nice.
We're primitive in our culture, just as, yes, I was listening as for your giraffe species. Yes, we are technology-wise, we are advanced. Third, fourth density. Some choose to be in third. Many choose us to be in fourth, but we all get along. We all still interact. We all communicate. We are explorers. We are hippie explorers, you could say.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, during your hippie movement, we were actually very much involved with that.
Really?
Oh, yes.
That's wonderful.
It's just, I mean, you know, if a humanoid horse would just appear, I don't think that would go too well. But our thoughts are... You know, our free love and all that.
Yes.
It's kind of evolved in your... That wasn't just us, it was others.
Uh-huh.
But we were definitely a contributor.
Yeah, but you enjoyed that energy.
Yes, your flower child. And
yes.
Your sundresses, flower... Yes, we love that stuff.
Aw. What do you do in your world?
Much. We do more of communicating with each other all the time. We are soul evolvers. We don't wish to take over the universe or evolve in too fast. We are very spiritual beings, so we keep to ourselves usually. We are very neutral, such as your Lakesh world. We are very similar.
Mm-hmm.
We have celebrations. We do evolve into a higher density. If we choose to, but we have
third. What is your density? I didn't ask that question.
I am in fourth, but we have many that are still third.
Uh-huh. Oh, okay. And what's your galaxy? Is it or a constellation?
Or planets?
Planet.
whatever is suitable.
Oh, currently, let's see what I'm allowed to give to you right at this moment.
Mm-hmm. Take your time.
Orion.
Oh, beautiful. Oh.
So how many species are in Orion? There's so many so far. Everyone's naming Orion. Like, what's going on?
It's a cluster, isn't it?
It's an infinite. And, of course, there's more galaxies, so there's more species out there that are horse-like in many ways. So,
wow.
Yes, even our music, I know it sounds from a horse, talking horse. Of course, you're talking about a talking horse. Much of your music actually came from us.
Really? What type of music?
I have a joy for banjo music.
Banjos. Yes, that's country.
Beautiful. What if we are so in love with our horses, the earth horses, that means we have connection with you, right?
Yes.
Beautiful. Mm-hmm.
Yes. Nice. Yes, our... You could say in the beginning of your world, we were brought to your planet to... We were contributing to your world. That's where our horse species is there right now.
Wonderful.
Note that many were invited to bring their species to your world, and so we were one of them. Many were chosen. Some planted their own animals, whatever they did, whatever they felt like. So, only good intentions, as far as I can tell.
So. Were you at one point like the horses on our Earth in your evolution?
Yes, very similar. It's a long story, which, yes, it's... Yes, in many ways, yes. Very similar to your awareness of evolution, which is still slightly a mystery. Mystery is always not... That's always good, actually.
Do you hang out in Earth? Also, do you hang out here sometimes when you see horses around?
Some do. Some, we don't. Yeah, there are actually many here, but they don't make their presence known.
Of course. I understand that.
They watch our collective, obviously, and also those that are horse lovers, we communicate with them.
Beautiful.
I mean, how else do you know how to handle or take care of horses? Where did that knowledge come from?
From your guide. Beautiful.
True.
Downloading.
Yes, correct.
Nice. What's your connection with the Arabian horses?
That is actually a different species altogether.
Really?
They're so decent and polite and peaceful. I love them.
Yes, but that is different than... I am more of a black stallion type of...
See, I was going to say that.
Okay, you look like one.
So there's different species for different horse species. So yes, we are abundant. There are several of us in the universe. We're just not well known on your world, that's all. Mm-hmm.
That is true, yes.
What do you enjoy doing?
Listening to music, chatting with my lady friends.
Oh. Very good.
That's the flower children. The flower child, I feel, originated from us, but some might disagree with that. Our species takes credit for that.
Oh, really?
Yes. Flower clothing, you notice how many of your dresses are covered in flowers. We take credit for that. Of course, a talking horse, yes, I know, it sounds, a horse gave us that idea. Yeah.
Yes. I wonder, would humans have had a lifetime on your planet?
Yes. More Palladian. Not
Palladian.
Palladians are, they come and go, but yes, they do communicate with us often.
So are there more than horse people on your planet, like other species?
Actually, the lion species.
The lion species are with you. Okay.
Wyrin, yes, but more of the lion than the Wyrin. But Wyrin also. They come visit every once in a while. We do communicate with them. The lion species, definitely.
Alex has a question.
We're kind of like a clip. What can you tell us about monatomic gold and its benefits to us and where we can get it?
Where you can get it? I'm not sure. There are those that wish you not to have that. So I believe it's very sacred, and whoever has it right now, they are keeping it quite a secret from your collective, or however you want to call yourselves.
Okay.
Lucas, can you help us in becoming a horse whisperer? Can you hear me?
Yes. Do you own a horse?
I used to have two horses in the past, but not now. But I love them so much. When I see pictures of horses, my goodness. Those are really noble entities.
But understand, you have this ability, you're just unaware of it.
I believe now it's getting better.
Yes. You just have to be open to it, that's all.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, yeah. We're very loving. We don't have negativity. I mean, there might be some that get angry every once in a while, but mostly we are a loving race.
Great, so you don't have benevolent negative entity at your race.
There are a few, but they're not with us. And There's always a few bad
entities. Yeah, there must be, of course.
Yes, we're not here. We're not judging them.
So you come and visit us astrally then?
Yes, if you don't mind to a talking horse, that is fine.
Beautiful, beautiful.
Flaxy, usually, normally. Even our third density species speaks with telepathy.
Uh-huh. Alan has a question.
Yes.
Hello there.
Hello.
I'm just wondering, are we the only planet shut off from seeing alien species side to side? Is there other planets in the same predicament as us?
Yes, there are others.
Okay, is there many?
Not this time. I don't believe it's... That's not knowledge that they wish to... I can tell you that there are two planets somewhat similar to yours.
Okay.
But more evolved technology-wise. But some are... they're not... They're like in a higher vibration of third density, but they are being prevented also, but for different reasons. But as for a reptilian... Of course, this world is very... unique. So the manipulation here is quite more advanced and fascinating, but not easy to live within, you understand, or however you word that.
Yeah.
To live in your life's journey is not easy, but beneficial. But yes, we'd love to come to your world and bring our banjo music and to... help you all the 2/4 density, if you're not mind talking to a talking horse.
I like your energy. I really like your energy.
I would love to speak with you, yes.
You're adorable. You're invited all the time.
I give you all hugs and kisses.
Beautiful.
Well, smooches to you too.
Yes, Your hippie part of your society has evolved in a way that is much beneficial. Has helped your evolution to this state of mind now. I wish more can be more laid back. Of course, many were seen as lazy and such, but not. Yes, lazy as productivity in your sense, but technically, spiritually, they are being. Not all of them, but many are very productive in their spirituality. And connecting to species and universes, they are not quite understanding. So basically, being a lazy hippie helps you connect to fourth density. That's what I'm getting at.
I'll take life.
Ah, you're adorable.
If your politicians were more like that, your world would be an easier place. If more people were laid back and just go with the flow.
Oh, the world would be a better place, definitely.
Yes, it would be.
Oh, I get that, definitely.
And we'll be lazy. Spiritually wise, it's not lazy. I mean, look at your job.
Being lazy better than being a negative entity. No problem.
Yes, I was picking up on that. Yes, correct.
Yes, of course. You like being lazy but cool and happy.
Yeah, exactly.
And spiritual, which is beautiful. You've got all that. You've got all that.
Yes. The more spiritual you are, the quicker your world evolves, but you know this. The more happy your collective will be, because many on your world are not too happy. Even within your colony, they are happy, but they wish they could evolve into a state of mind where they can finally speak to their galactic friends on a personal level, on a one-to-one level. But I believe that's coming, but yes, it's not soon enough. But
This is the point.
Yes.
So when you see people that being lazy and they're not spiritual, so can you come and do something for them? Like give them something?
Yes. Then you go into a depressive state where they wish not to come out of it. Some do, some don't. Some wish to be depressed, but they must... Some must have what you call a darkness of the soul. Some need to go through that. That is part of your world's evolution. That's the reason why some of you are here. To go into that dark place to hopefully find where you hit. So at rock bottom so far is like you hit that part. It's like, I don't want to be here anymore. I have finally reached my ultimate low. Now I just want to be happy and to never go there ever again because it's silly and it's just not right. Of course, some go into darkness and they never come out, but anyway. But yes, we do send energies to those that are...
Beautiful. How about the reptilians? Are they in your scope? Do you see them and you repel them or do something with them?
We send them hugs and kisses, but they do not respond to any of that.
Of course. That's definitely true.
Yes, they don't see us as a threat. Of course, we're not a threat anyway. But yes, we send them love and grace, and they don't respond to that. And yes, they don't talk to us very much.
Mm-hmm.
At least the negative ones.
What about the vice versa? When you see them attacking humans, can you do something from that?
Oh, yeah. Yes, we can give knowledge to how to escape. You can say talk your way out of it. Yes, we can send energies like that. Yes, correct.
Beautiful. Beautiful.
Yes, we know about reptilians, but we try to stay away from them. But we do. We are aware.
Do you hang around horse races or something?
Yes, some of us do. Yes. Mm. It is quite amusing how the money and all that goes, greed.
Yeah.
Yes, it's fascinating.
Did we ask you your name? Sorry about that.
Lucas,
okay. Go ahead.
Some of those horses that are within that race actually enjoy being a part of it. Some don't. Some don't want anything to do with it, but they have to. But many of those horses do enjoy being a part of that race. So I'm not sure if that was a question, but I figure I'll throw that out there.
What kind of contribution your civilization bring to this universe?
To be more hippie-like, to be more loving, to... Such as your world, where there's so much darkness on top of it, so much darkness, we can actually teach civilizations to reverse that process and to bring light and love. On your world, we do that, but not on a huge basis. There's too many other entities here.
Are you smoke weed like the hippies we have here?
What was that? Smoke weed? Is that what you said?
Yeah.
Something like that.
Yeah, like sick weed, okay.
We have air like that. Yes, we are high as a kite already, so technically we don't need it. But someone in our third density have tried that.
Someone have asked if what kind of building or you create or what look your cities?
They're more natural civilization. It's more... I don't know if I have to connect to that. It's more... You know how you have cement buildings here? Ours are more natural created. That's... doesn't make any sense, but we do have structures, but not as hot and tall as your skyscrapers. We do have shops. They're in our third density level. The fourth, we don't need any of that, but in our third density, it's somewhat similar to your world. We're more cleaner, more... everybody's friendlier, of course.
And what is your height?
It's very primitive, actually. 6 feet tall, some are 7. I'm 6.
Like regular horse's height?
Yes.
Uh-huh, regular, okay.
Some are 8 feet tall. It varies.
Oh!
And is there a humanoid unicorn species?
One moment. Yes, there is.
Oh, great, thank you.
We are not communications, but they do exist.
I give you a possibility to make connection with me and send me some picture of your civilization. Thanks.
All of us, of course, we love you all.
Of course.
I have a question. Hello.
Yes.
Is your body muscle? How can I say that? With the muscle?
Have muscles. Have muscles.
Basti.
She wants to know if you're strong.
Yes.
He's a horse. Yes. Come on.
Well, yes, we are very strong, but we are loving beings. Don't go around crushing everybody, but yes, we are strong.
How about your hands, fingers?
Our hands are strong, yes, but we aren't.
How many fingers?
5 fingers. We are humanoid.
Wow. How about your toes? Like a human toes?
Toys.
Toys, yes.
Did you have toys? Are you saying that?
Or pets? No. No, she's talking about toes.
Yes.
Yes. Some do have your. Some haven't evolved. They have horse legs, so some have not evolved into humanoid completely. So some of us have legs very similar to yours, but some do not.
What about you?
It's very similar to your. I have 3 toes.
I'm curious to know what is the biggest entity which have a density like us and positive in this universe?
Do you mean tallest, Mark?
Tall and big and...
Tall and big, okay.
And have a density like us. So it was not a spirit.
You're wondering if there's a race like similar to yours but taller?
Yeah, bigger, taller, already the biggest, yeah.
Well, as for giants, you mean?
Yeah. In the past, they used to have 50 feet tall giants. Do they exist in the universe?
Well, yes. I am not in communications with them, but their population is not vast like yours. But yes, it exists.
They are positive?
As far as I'm concerned... yes.
Can you send a message to them? We are open to make connection when they are ready.
I believe they heard that. Yes, correct.
Okay, thanks then.
Beautiful. Do they have a name, those giants?
I don't think they want that out there right now.
Okay, no problem.
In time they will. I believe they will.
Okay. Beautiful.
And your Anunnaki also, they have a planet of giants also.
I see. Because we as humans, we were tall at one stage. We were that 50 feet tall. And then we shrink down.
Yes.
By time. Yes. So we have a link with them anyway. Good. Any final message, Lucas?
A message?
Yeah. For us, for everybody, or something in your head. Yeah.
Oh, for you, for us, for everybody.
Whatever you feel like, yeah, whatever you feel like. You have something to say.
Well, be more hippie, be more loving. Tell your governments you just shut it down, whatever they got going.
Yeah.
And just start loving each other.
We do. Our human inclination is all about that.
Well, no. But yes, I understand.
Oh, no, but yes. Okay.
Some wish not to be very loving. They like to be mean and ugly and you know what I mean. We send them love, too.
Okay.
They will learn eventually.
Do you have a galactic language that we can hear? So can you be blessed?
Let's see here. Let's see if I can get anything through. Only thing I have here for your because our language is not easy to say.
Okay.
I can give you somewhat of a kind of an idea. It goes, that's about it.
It's beautiful.
Yes, I believe this vessel, they're concentrating on more connections in languages at this point.
Uh-huh, yeah.
What I just spoke, was that more like yours?
Yes. Yes, very... very close, yes.
What about
just
this one?
Just one word.
Hold on, Sarah. What?
Just one word. I love you.
Okay. Wow. We do all do. He knows
in
that.
In any language, they have that, you know.
Yes, what? Just that one in one? Your language. Yeah.
Lucas. This came out.
That is not from our species, but that is a neighboring species.
Orion, okay. Sounds good.
Yes, I must go. So.
Thank you very much. We love you all.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lucas.
Thank you. Hugs to you. Kisses.
Love and blessings and hugs and whatever you wish.
Next time, bring galactic weed with you.
Yeah,
we have someone which love that.
Yeah, I am aware of that. I will think about that next time.
Thank you for coming.
Whoa.
Hello, Ivan. Welcome.
Hello, Ivan. It was wonderful energy.
Yeah, that was different.
Is there more that we don't know? My goodness me.
I'm sure there's so many stars and galaxies.
Yeah.
My
goodness. Yeah.
Every day I'm surprised, you know?
God. Yeah, if you can imagine it, it's out there.
Yeah. This came to my mind, yeah.
Yeah, because you're receiving actually a download. You think it's imagination, but it's actually a download.
Uh-huh. True.
Ivan, you're just connecting with the energy, and you cannot see them.
I'm not sure.
Can you see them? Like,
yes.
Their forms?
So, yes, they...
So I was right, he's handsome.
Yes, yes.
Horses are handsome, my goodness. They look so noble, my God.
Did you be able to feel the giant energy?
Giant energy? Yeah, I felt that. Yes.
What that look?
I didn't get what they looked like, but yeah, they're huge.
Okay, giant energy.
he said his regular height, like our horses, is as high as them. Yeah. So this his regular. Then.
Are you ready for a ride, Noah?
No.
I love horses. I used to have them, you know. I love them so much.
Yeah, horses are very.
Wait, the horses when they're in a back feet standing, that's the high, because he looks like a human and head is horse. That's how he looks like.
He's a humanoid. He has the body of a human and head of a horse.
Yeah,
and
he has the body.
And he's 6 feet high. But that's he's fair enough. He's tall for a regular horse, you know.
Yeah, but yeah, there's some.
And busty, yes.
Tonight, I love you.
That's great.
No, I already imagine him. He's 6 feet tall and he's busty. He's big, you know. He's not tiny. He's big. He can be like 2 feet wide. He can be big.
Imagine when. Imagine when the horse make a kick.
What, no, Mark?
No. These ones don't kick.
Kick, ours kick?
No, these ones don't kick. They hug.
They hug?
Hug.
Oh, hug. I was just imagining a horse hopping.
Do we want to do blessings? So we can.
D'accord, I'll do.
I do.
Okay, tari tari ta kati kara tari turu raka di 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 kati kuro tu tari ta di 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 turu di di kati kuro tu ta 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 tu turu tu tu. Blessings to all.
Shikirini, kya tu kiri shudda katka yutu nengaya pasakta gaya shini okata gaya. Kotei sikatakaina kahi sakatakadeu shutukultayanta. Tatatanu kutukati sana kutu katakatakadini sikatigia shutuayata. Kana kutu shitake naneniki hutukati shitaya tatata tukunu atakanoku sikiti hatani kaisu kaisa katakatai shutuha. Ta 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 nu hu shi ti ni ya sa ya ku tu ha ta.
Yeah, thank you.
You're welcome. Namaste.
Okay, thank you guys for being here in the broadcast.
Cheers, Ivan.